Everywhere you look around, there's a logo connected to a company, whether big or small. And today, we're going to get into the origins of BET. BET, which is short for Black Entertainment Television, is an American cable television network and multimedia group providing news, entertainment, and other programming developed primarily for African American viewers. BET also operates a channel geared toward African American women called BET Her, which features contemporary and 20th century popular music through BET Gospel, BET Hip Hop, BET Jams, and BET Soul. It also produces documentaries and movies for distribution on the BET channel and sponsors the BET Awards. The company's headquarters are located in Washington, D.C. The owner of the company, Robert L. Johnson, wanted to have a show that reached out to African Americans. He would soon acquire a loan for $15,000 and a $500,000 investment from media executive John Malone to start the network. The network, which was named BET Black Entertainment Television, launched on January 25, 1980. Cheryl D. Miller designed a logo that would represent the network, which featured a star to symbolize black star power. Initially broadcasted for 2 hours a week, the network's lineup composed of music videos and reruns of popular black sitcoms. It would not be until 1983 that BET became a full-fledged entity independent of any other channel or programming block. In some markets, the network would not arrive at all until as late as early 2010, with Viacom doing negotiations to carry the BET network with Viacom Network, due to some providers claiming that there was an overall lack of demand for the channel, or there was a low to non-existent black population within their service area. BET launched a news program, BET News, in 1988 with Ed Gordon as its anchor. Gordon later hosted other programs and specials on BET, such as Black Men Speak Out, The Aftermath, related to the 1992 Los Angeles riots, and a recurring interview show, Conversations with Ed Gordon. In 1996, the talk show BET Tonight debuted with Travis Smiley as host. In 2001, Ed Gordon replaced Smiley as host of the program. In 1991, the network became the first black-controlled TV company to be listed on the New York Stock Exchange. Starting the late 1990s, the network expanded with the launch of Digital Cable Network, what is now the general interest channel BET Her, originally launched as BET on Jazz, which was created originally to showcase jazz music-related programming, especially that of African-American jazz musicians, in 1998. In 1998, it entered into a joint venture with Starz to launch a multiplex service of the premium channel featuring African-American-oriented movies called BET Movies. Starz 3 was later renamed Black Starz after BET dropped out of the venture following its purchase by Viacom. In 2001, the network lost its status as a black-owned business when it was bought by media conglomerate Viacom for $3 billion. In 2005, Johnson retired from the network, turning over his titles of president and chief executive officer to former BET vice president Deborah L. Lee. By 2007, the network had launched two more music-oriented networks, BET Hip Hop and BET Gospel. BET also launched a batch of original programming by this time, including reality shows Baldwin Hills and Hell Date, competition show Sunday Best, and town hall-style discussion show Hip Hop vs. America. BET's President of Entertainment, Reginald Hoodlum, resigned from the network on September 11, 2008. He was then replaced by Stephen Hill, who was also Executive Vice President of Music Programming and Talent. BET announced in March 2010 that Ed Gordon would return to the network to host a variety of news programs and specials. BET's programming began with a wide range of comedy, news and current affairs, public affairs and music programming, including mainstream rap, hip-hop, and R&B music videos, which now air on its branded sister network, and the network's former flagship program, 106 and Park, which debuted on September 11, 2000, and ended on December 19, 2014. In March 2017, President of Programming Stephen Hill and Executive Vice President of Original Programming Zola Mashariki both stepped down. Connie Orlando, Senior Vice President of Specials, Music Programming, and News, was named the Interim President of Programming. In July 2017, Viacom signed new film and television development deals with Tyler Perry following the expiration of his existing pact with Discovery Incorporated in 2019. As part of this deal, Perry would produce The Oval and Sisters for BET and co-own the network's newly launched streaming service, BET+. In a 2010 interview, BET co-founder Sheila Johnson said that she herself is ashamed of what the network has become. She said, and I quote, "I don't watch it. I suggest to my kids that they don't watch it. When we started BET, it was going to be the Ebony magazine on television. We had public affairs programming. We had news. I had a show called Teen Summit. We had a large variety of programming. But the problem is that when the video revolution started up, and then something started happening, and I didn't like it at all. And I remember during those days, we would sit up and watch these videos and decide which ones were going on and which ones were not. We got a lot of backlash from recording artists, and we had to start showing them. I didn't like the way women were being portrayed in these videos. As a result, BET heavily censors suggestive content from the videos that it airs, often with entire verses and scenes removed from certain rap videos. BET is now being broadcasted around the world in many countries and has developed many sister stations and spin-offs from its original work, and its parent company that it's under is estimated to be worth about $15 billion. If you enjoyed this video and want to be updated on future videos coming up, please hit the like, subscribe button, and thank you for watching.